Hello everyone, welcome to Shadi's Tarot Tea. So, I said I wasn't going to do a reading on him on Juice WRLD because I didn't want another catastrophe like when I read on Nipsey. So I was a little apprehensive to read on him, guys. But you know what? Like, I asked him for permission. We all know that I read on the past, the people that have passed. I read on them in a very tasteful way. I come with great intentions. Let me make that very clear. I understand that, you know, he just passed. I understand that. So that's why I went ahead, because I did get a request to read on him, and I'm sure other people have been in my comments. I haven't really been on my YouTube channel for a minute just because I was taking a break and, like, you know, I've been working and stuff, so I understand that he just passed away. I do get that, guys. His birthday was on December 2nd, which is why I actually, guys, believe it or not, I took the time to really meditate on his energy, on Jarad's energy, and I know nothing about him. I really don't. I didn't even know he was a singer. He sounds like he was a singer and he was a rapper. And I'm going to be very honest. I'm going to be very candid in this video. I have no reason to do this for views or anything like that, which is why people, you know, I saw a psychic reader post about how people do this for, like, views and, like, you know, you got to let the living, like, I mean, the passing, you got to let them. I saw a post that a psychic reader made on how, like, it's very distasteful to, like, read on people when they have just passed, which I understand. I understand that. But what I like to do is meditate on their energy, because as you guys know, the makeup world, like the psychic world, is very competitive, and I hate that. I hate that about this psychic world. When I started reading on people, I did this strictly because I love what I do. I love reading on people. I love reading on celebrities. I love reading on us as a whole. I love connecting with people that have passed, okay? So when psychic readers try to turn each other against each other, listen, you guys, I wasn't going to say anything about this, but it's something that really pisses me off about the, you know, the competition in the psychic world. I'm not here to compete with anybody. I'm here to compete with myself. I'm here to be the best self that I can be. And I'm not going to listen to other psychic readers that are saying, oh, you know, when someone just passes, it's not good to read on them. Listen, if spirit doesn't want us to read on them, they won't allow us. I always say this in my channel. I always say that spirit knows who is genuine and they know who is not. So if that psychic reader got a no, you might want to think about why they got that no, okay? Because if you're genuine, it doesn't matter if it's good or bad, okay? Spirit will feel it. Spirit will say, that person that has passed, you know, like when I read on Nipsey, he said, go ahead, but, there was a but, you speak nice on my name, basically. Not that he thought I wouldn't or anything. It's just because other psychics were getting into the drama of his life, you know what I mean? And when I read on Aaliyah, same thing, you know, she didn't want people to read on her because, you know, she had so many psychics reading on her and she was tired. She wanted to transition. Same with Michael. Michael told me no, you know, but then I just, you know, read on his chart, which he was okay with. But then, as you guys saw in my video, he started opening up. So I don't like when other psychic readers get on their posts or they get on their channel and they say, you know, they try to put other psychic readers against each other. Let's support each other, okay? We're all doing the same thing. We're all speaking, you know, we're all trying to be nice to the spirits and we're all doing the same thing. I don't understand this whole stupid competition. Okay. And Juice WRLD, I understand that he just passed away. That is the whole thing for my post here, is not to call anybody out. But it really upsets me because I actually got an okay from him. He didn't, and another thing is that we're not exactly talking to him, is what the psychic said. How do you know that? You don't know who we're talking to. You don't know. You know what I mean, guys? So I know, only we know our abilities. No other psychic reader can tell someone else what their abilities are. And on my channel, I try to, yes, I'm calling people out, but I don't like the negativity that's in the psychic community. It pisses me off. And I do want to make a video about this because it really irks me. Because if you're operating from a higher energy, like you say you are, you shouldn't be putting other psychic readers down. You shouldn't be like, oh, well, they're not actually hearing that person. You don't know what that psychic reader is capable of. Okay? So, and you don't know exactly how that psychic connected with that spirit. Now, if the psychic connected with the spirit and they said no and they still did it, then that's on them. That's their karma. But who are we to call people out and say that they're not actually hearing people? Like, that's so negative and that's so fucked up. And I'm tired of hearing that. You know what I mean? It's not, I hear it and it's annoying. So the reason I said this is I'm going to go ahead and disable the comments because I don't want Gerard to, I don't want this negativity around his video, okay? The truth is, guys, is that he was very sad living on this earth. And I was listening to, I played that song Empty from him because that was exactly, guys, what I was feeling from him. He felt very empty in this world. I actually feel like Gerard was very intuitive, super duper intuitive. I say that a lot on my channel, but I feel that from him. He felt things beyond our worlds. You know, he felt things like he picked up, I don't know what his rising's in. It must be in water, like it must be in Scorpio, Cancer, or Pisces, because he picked up on like Summer Walker, like he picks up on energies. He's very clairsentient and he picks up on things around his environment and he takes on his environment. And that was part of why, unfortunately, he lived a very fast life. He lived a very fast life. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. But you know what? Which is why I was a little bit apprehensive because I don't want to come on here and just be like, you know, he did this and he did that. No, that's not what his reading's gonna be about, guys. He, you know, which is what brought me back to what I said in the beginning. I connected with him. I did. And he was telling me he wasn't really talking a lot to me, but he did say through his energy and a little bit of his words and his music that I just played, that song Empty, he pointed me to that song and he said, this was how I felt. This was exactly what was going on in my world, and I spoke about it. I feel like there were a lot of, without even pulling my cards on him, guys, I feel like there were a lot of people around him that were very influenced by his energy, and he allowed people at the same time to influence how he moved, you know. And I feel from him, he would try to do the right thing. He would try to get on the right track, like I said about Mac Miller. But again, this music industry is very toxic. You know, it's a very toxic world we live in. You know what I'm saying? And unfortunately, with his clairsentience and how clairvoyant he was too, he attracted energy vampires to him. It's not even funny, the sadness I feel from him. And I was looking at some of his photos because, again, like I said, I meditated on his energy. I meditated and I really went into his energy, guys. I'm not even fucking with you. Like, I wanted to make sure that he was okay. And that's why I don't like when psychics say shit like that. Like, oh, well, he just passed. Like, that's so fucking rude. And why are you gonna hop on that bandwagon? It's not a bandwagon. Okay, maybe some psychics are doing it not genuinely. But I'm not gonna lump myself into there. I'm not gonna allow some other psychic to lump me into that bandwagon. Hell no. I do this because I love reading on these celebrities. And if you guys have followed my channel and you're a true listener of my words, then you will know that my message for Gerard is genuine. And I feel like a lot of people are hurting over his death, unfortunately. His family is very hurt, much hurt. I pick up on a mother influence from him that was very hurt by the fact that he passed, and I feel a bunch of sadness around him. You know, and that's, you know, he just passed, so of course people would feel that. But the main thing I want to say, guys, is that what he told me is he wants this to be a very positive space. He was someone that lived his life in total darkness. I'm not even playing with you guys. I feel that. I picked up on it so strongly. He had a lot of things weighing him down. I don't want to say he had demons, but I feel like the demons that Gerard had weren't really because of him. It was because of the people that placed those their own demons on him. Yes, he had things that he was battling, and I understand. I barely looked at the tabloids. Apparently there was something with, they found stuff in his plane or something. I don't even want to deal with that. I don't even want to address that. And when I was meditating, guys, I'm sorry, I'm gonna get into his reading. I just want to make this very clear. When I was meditating on him, he wanted me to give a message to you guys. That's what this reading is gonna be about. We're not gonna focus on his death. Like, he doesn't want it to be about that. He already dealt with enough darkness in this world, and he wants it to be very uplifting. And he also wants me to talk a bit about the kind of person he was, because a lot of people misunderstood him. A lot of people didn't understand his intent. You know, he had great intent, really, he did. Unfortunately, he just allowed the wrong types of people into his life to make him move in a certain way. And there's a difference between someone that moves selfishly and someone that believes they're supposed to move selfishly. And the first thing that I got for him was the nurturing card, which was beautiful. And he has his moon in Taurus, guys, and he's a Sagittarius. You know, that moon in Taurus, I felt that. I felt his nurturing energy. It was great. It was, oh my God, guys, I wish you could feel it. It was great. Like I said, I wasn't gonna do this reading, but I just chose to try because I know a lot of his fans are hurting and they want a message, and that's what this video is gonna be about. It's gonna be who he was as a person, and it's gonna be about what messages spirit, you know, and you know, spirit, he wants me to go through spirit, not all the way with him, because like I said, he is still passing and we wanna respect that. I am genuine when I read on people. Okay, guys. So let's go ahead and see the type of person he was. So the first thing, like I said, that I picked up on was the nurturing card. He was someone that was very nurturing when he brought you into his family. He treated a lot of people like they were his family. And this unfortunately was something he's telling me that he felt was his downfall. He knew it was something that he had to stop doing, but unfortunately he was a giver. And to his detriment, I mean, not unfortunately he because of him being a giver. He was a giver in the sense that he did too much. He gave too much. You know what, guys? Like, I really relate to his energy. I'm not even playing with you guys. I have a lot of his placements. I have Sagittarius, and he has his Mars in Libra. And he has his, I'm gonna go ahead and read his chart up here. Sun in Sagittarius with his Moon in Taurus, his Mercury in Sagittarius, his Venus in Sag, and his Mars is in Libra. Again, I don't know what his rising's in, but I'm gonna say it's in Scorpio. I feel like he has a heavy, I felt Scorpio from him. He may not be a Scorpio rising, but I feel some heavy Scorpio influence from him. Maybe it's that Chiron in Scorpio, but you know, who he was in a past life is the Chiron. I've been, you know, doing more chart readings and you know, just with my friend, and we've been really educating ourselves on the placements, so I can speak a lot more on who these people are, you know what I mean? So I've been diving into chart reading so I can get better. But yes, I'm feeling a pull on that Chiron in Scorpio and maybe his rising in water. Yeah, he was definitely someone that I keep seeing his smile. He has a great smile about him. He has a great wit, a great charm about him. He was someone that was very smart in the way he said jokes. He would come back at you with, you know, he just had the first thing I felt for him is he had a great sense of humor, guys. And that doesn't surprise me, honestly, because he's a Sagittarius, and Sagittariuses have such a great light about them. They have such a great personality. They have a bigger than life personality. And you know, Jarad had a big personality. I feel that from him. He was someone that loved to make people laugh, even if he was hurting. He loved to make people laugh, and he would channel a lot of that in his music. Again, guys, I feel a heavy Scorpio influence. I feel like he picked up on a lot of things, and what I was hearing from his music a little bit, I'm not a fan. Like I said, I don't, not in a bad way, I just didn't know much about, I don't know anything about this man. But he has great light. He is transitioning. God is helping him heal, okay? If fans want to know that, he is healing. He is transcending, which is beautiful, guys. Oh my God, so beautiful that I feel that for him. Yeah, he, Three of Cups, he took his friends very seriously, guys. He was very loyal, very honest, When he spoke to people, they knew he was being honest. He tended to be a little bit too blunt, especially with his jokes. He would say things kind of at people's expense, you know, to get them laughing. He liked to, not in a bad way, but he just liked to make people laugh at themselves because he didn't like when people took themselves so seriously, even though, you know, Gerard had a very dark sense of humor and he at times would take himself seriously. It was more of like an inner, like he would self-reflect, you know what I'm saying? That's when he took himself seriously, but he would do this in private. He would do this when, you know, no one was around. There were a couple of friends around him, I am feeling, that were positive, that would tell him like, hey, like, you know, Gerard, you know, you have to do this. You have to, I am here and get clean, you know? So guys, I don't know. I'm not gonna, like I said, this isn't about that. But there were some things that he was battling for sure, as we all are as humans. But he feels great, guys. He feels like a really good person. Oh my God. Six of Swords. He had a deep, deep fear, guys. Let me tell you, he had a great deep fear of letting people down. He didn't like letting people down. This is very Sagittarius of him. He doesn't like letting people down. He doesn't like disappointing people, especially when it came to his friends and being pulled to. When it came to his friends, he really, and his family, he was very much a family-oriented person. He was very stubborn. He does have his moon in Taurus, and he's a Sag, could be also a Sag rising, maybe. Okay. Beautiful. What I am hearing is that he has lived his life. He will not have to come back. The Wheel of Fortune is in the upright, telling me that he will not have to come back. His karmic debt has been paid. I'm not saying that he was a sacrifice or anything. People could take it that way. He wasn't a part of the Illuminati. I know when I did my Nipsey video, people were like, so you think he was a sacrifice? I don't know about Nipsey, but I'm saying I don't think so. But I'm saying Gerard was not a sacrifice, if we're not gonna even go there, okay? He was someone that learned his karma on this earth. He learned from you. He learned, even though he was stubborn, he learned from his environment. He picked up, I keep getting this from him, guys. I'm not even playing with you. He picked up on his environment pretty easily. Very easily, he picked up on his environment. He was someone that, it's interesting, the energy I'm pulling from him. It's very heavy, but it's light at the same time. It's not completely dark, you know, because through his darkness, this is very Sagittarius of him, through his darkness, he saw the light. He did see things for what it was. He was a very realistic type of energy, but he learned his lesson already, guys. I don't feel like he has to come back. He does feel like he's walked this earth a lot, and that's he does carry a lot of his past lives with him. In his Chiron and Scorpio, like I said, I keep being pulled to that. He has his Pluto in Sagittarius. That is beautiful, guys. Let me tell you something. That is what I'm feeling. Oh God, that is beautiful. He has his Pluto in Sagittarius. So Pluto in Sag, it's his whole mission on this earth, guys, was to teach, was to enlighten, was hit for himself, was to learn. Learn all you can on this earth, okay? And that is exactly what he did. He learned. So he feels like, guys, I am hearing, and I've heard him say, the little words he did say to me, I did hear him say that I knew I was gonna pass. I knew. He's like, I knew, even though, because he just felt a great amount of sadness. And that's kind of why he feels like he didn't owe it to anyone to explain. He was someone that didn't really like to explain his motives. He didn't really, you know, if you were his friend, if you were close with him, that's very Sagittarius of him. If you were close with him, you were close with him and you knew him as a person. You knew his motives. You knew the light he brought to this earth. Okay. He was someone that didn't like to explain himself. He didn't like to make excuses or say sorry for his motives or his, unless he felt he was really wrong. Okay. I'm not saying he was a heartless person, but this is his shadow side. He did move recklessly. Okay, guys. He is telling me that as well. I heard him as I meditated and I'm hearing him say reckless. But that's very Sagittarius. They move recklessly when they're just that, they're a fire sign. Fire signs, when they just don't care and they want to live their life, you know, Sagittariuses are the party animals too of the zodiac. You know, that's what they do. They love to have fun. He liked to not take stuff seriously. Although he did have moments of solace, you know, he had moments where, you know, the tower. Okay. he definitely had moments where he did get down on himself. He did take himself seriously, but he didn't like to show this side to people. I feel like there were two layers to Jarad. Like there was a layer that he exuded to the world, which was, I'm this happy-go-lucky, jokey type of dude. Like I like to make I hear he's saying like, I like to throw pranks. I like to make you the butt of jokes. Like that was like my personality. That was something that I loved doing. Like I like clowning on my friends. I like going out and playing basketball and hanging out with my dudes and like, getting in tune with, what Jarad liked to do. I'm picking up on his mother, like I said already. I don't know if his mom is a Queen of Pentacles or Queen. She did come out as the Queen of Swords in my Rider-Waite tarot, guys. She came out as the Queen of Pentacles. I mean, Queen of Swords, excuse me. I also feel like he was guarded. He was very guarded, but there was a lot of pressure put on him. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. And sometimes he just needed to unwind. Sometimes he just needed. So he did, sometimes he did do things that, others wouldn't approve of. That's what I will say. Okay. But again, we're not gonna focus on that. I want this to be very positive, and he doesn't want me to focus on that. Knight of Cups, he was someone that really loved. When he loved hard, he loved. Like he has that moon in Taurus. But he was a bit, he is saying that he was a bit of a little playboy. But he liked, he just loved love, man. He loved love. The Tower card, he knew, I'm telling you guys, he knew. He knew his journey here. He knew that there was a big moment coming up for him. He wasn't shocked actually when he passed, when it happened. It happened very quickly. I'm seeing him say it happened very quickly. Yeah, there were some problems in his family, but you know what? He feels like his passing, he feels like that is bringing his family closer. Even though his mom was in his life, I'm feeling like he's saying that there wasn't a lot of connection with his mother. His mother is coming out as the Queen of Pentacles now in the reverse. I keep hearing his mom. Something about his mother, and the Ten of Pentacles in the reverse came out, which signifies family. He was so, stubborn, and she hated that about him. But he tried his best to take care of his family for sure. He's a very family-oriented man for sure. There were moments where he would get down, like I keep saying about, and that's normal, we're human. He's saying that he oftentimes would test his own strength, but he felt, I'm hearing him say he felt weak. He felt weak a lot of times. Like there was too much pressure on him. I keep hearing that from him. There was too much pressure. Ten of Wands, I keep being pulled to pull out with the Strength card. There was a lot of pressure on him, a lot of debts he owed. 'Cause his money wasn't right. Something about his money, he's saying, wasn't right. So either people owed him money, like I always say, I don't like to just point the finger at the artist, but either people owed him money or he wasn't making enough money like he wanted to. And he feels like, I feel like this from him too, like he wasn't really respected until this passing. We're gonna see a lot of money come out for him. We're gonna see his money. His music's gonna, like, if it hasn't already, it's gonna skyrocket. It's gonna sell. Yeah, release in the reverse. He's learned to release, or he's learning to release. Let's do a spiritual message for him, because again, he wants us to be very uplifting. He wants us to be very positive. Okay, guys, so we're gonna respect his wishes. Like I said, I do that. Okay, guys, so I have pulled a couple of spiritual messages for you guys, and for Jarad, he is and his family. Jarad is healing. I feel like he is be a he's releasing. It's so beautiful, guys. Like he, let me tell you one thing, is that Jarad was very sad on this earth. Like, oh my God, most artists are, right? Because they just deal with so much, but he is releasing. God is helping him release. It's so beautiful, and he actually is transcending, which is so beautiful. Oh my God. And I hope his family sees this, because he is, I know it's not easy, but he is learning to release, and he's doing it a lot faster than most spirits I've felt, to be honest with you guys. I'm not even kidding with you. Yeah, he was going through a lot, challenging times. He got my challenging times card as I pulled. But he's releasing that, which is beautiful. Crown chakra in the reverse. I feel like there were a lot of signs, and he's saying too for his fans and for his family. He did pay attention to the signs, but unfortunately, it's something he's very intuitive, but he saw a lot of red flags coming up before he listen in the reverse. Wow, guys. Telling you, he felt it and he heard it. I don't know if people were warning him too. Yeah. I feel like Gerard would try to tell people things and they would not listen to him. Like he would have deep some people, which is when he learned who his friends were. He had a lot of deep thoughts. And if you look at photos of him, I'm gonna post this photo that I noticed. He has a lot of sadness in his eyes. A lot of, like I always say, the windows are to the soul. And when I see people, like in my crown chakra, I see their eyes. And I pay attention so much to his eyes. Like a lot of sadness in his eyes. A lot of wanting to escape, you know? As well. But I feel like, to go back to what I said, I feel like, you know, I feel like Gerard said a lot of deep poetic things, and like he had some people around him that he would try. This is how he moved and learned who his friends were and who cared about him, even in his family. I feel like there was a lot going on with his family too. I did get my Ten of Pentacles in the reverse, but I feel like there was a lot of he tried to explain to people like what he was feeling and how he would like view things in certain types of intuitive messages he would get, but they were just like, "What, dude? Like, what are you talking about? Like I don't understand." And I so get that. Like, oh, I connect so much to his energy, guys. I'm not even playing with you. I've never connected so much to someone other than Mac. I connected very well to him, but Gerard, I know nothing about this man, and wow, connect so much to him, guys. Connect, and that's why. I'm saying that's why he's allowing me to read on him, because I'm hearing him. You know what I'm saying? And like I always say, they know who's genuine and who's not. So, you know, and that's why I was saying in my Michael video, at first it was a no because he was scared. But then, you know, he allowed me to read on his chart, and then he felt my energy out and he opened up a bit, you know, and then he left. And that's how spirit moves, you know what I'm saying? So Gerard is a lot more open with me, but not all the way open. He has that moon in Taurus, and he has that Sag energy and, you know, Libra energy, and you know, this is some of the signs that these are some of the signs that even though they seem open, they're not. You know, they're very detached, you know, which brings me to my detached card. Is that because people didn't really take him seriously sometimes and they didn't understand a lot of the things he was saying, he did detach a lot. He did detach from people. He did detach from his family. He did detach from anybody that would try to be an opportunist. He saw that. He saw people for who they were. I'm telling you, he was very realistic, very realistic. Just because he laughed, he's saying just because he laughed, he said things, he, you know, he kept things light, doesn't mean he didn't see people. You know, and that's why I'm feeling he has like a Scorpio rising, or he has like a water rising, Cancer, Pisces rising, because he saw it. You know, he saw people for who they were. And this could be his Sagittarius energy. Sagittarius is see. They're very realistic people. They see it, you know. But he had a big amount of love that he gave people. It was so great. And his you know, he didn't quite feel like he was supposed to be all the way like leading people. So he would step back, but spirit is calling him now in the spiritual realm to lead, to be who he felt he couldn't be in the physical, to be it in the spiritual, because he does have a lot to say. He will get another opportunity in the spirit realm to live out his truth, to say what he wants to say, to be a preacher. And that's what I felt like he was afraid of. He was afraid of that side of him. He was afraid to be a leader. But guys, like his energy, he is a leader, and that's what's so beautiful about this reading, is that, you know, Gerard had such great potential. I'm not even bullshitting you guys. You know, if you follow me by now, you know I don't bullshit, right? He has such great potential, but you know, he was afraid to lead. because people never gave him confidence that they would listen, right? And that's honestly what happens sometimes when we want to lead, but no one is listening. Leaders don't always get listened to. That's just the reality of it. And he is learning to release that. His relationship with his mom, I keep feeling something about that. His family, that's very private to him. He wants his family to know that he's okay. He is releasing, he forgives them, and he wants them to forgive themselves. Okay. He's calling me to say something about his family. So let's go ahead and do that. And then we'll go ahead and wrap up this reading. Like I said, I don't want this reading to get too long. Well, I didn't say that, but I don't want this reading to get too long because I don't want to get into his what actually happened. He doesn't want me to focus on that. I got a hard no with that. So guys, I am respecting that, okay? I am respecting that. So he wants this to be a very uplifting video and a little bit realistic. He doesn't want me to sugarcoat things because that's very Sagittarius. They don't like that. So he's like, find the balance, So let's see what messages he has. Actually, let me do this deck. Let's see what messages he has for his family. Okay, guys, wow, this is beautiful. So, if Gerard's family ever comes across this video, this is a beautiful message. He first wants to let you guys know that he absolutely loves you. He loves you guys, okay? He's saying, please forgive yourselves. He's forgiven you. Please forgive yourselves for whatever has transpired between you guys, whatever has happened. He's forgiven you. That's what that's saying to me. He's grown a lot from the things that you have taught him. His parents taught him certain things on the earth, that in the physical, that he's learned and he's taking into his lifetime in the spiritual world, okay? His next lifetime, excuse me, in the spiritual world. And he wants you guys to rebuild this unity, rebuild, learn from what happened, learn from him. Okay? Learn from him. Rebuild. Don't let his death cause any destruction. Don't let his death make you guys crumble. That's not what he wanted, or that's not what he's saying he wants. Okay? Rebuild. Learn, love, and rebuild and laugh. He loves that. He loves to laugh, guys, I'm telling you. Rebuild, love. Okay. He's saying right now there's someone that this message is for that he was very spiritual with. He's very in tune with. He's saying, I don't know if this is one of his parents or he's not telling me, but whoever this message is for, he's saying that he is not ready yet. He's not ready. He's still releasing. There was a lot of pain that I guess they caused him. But he's not ready yet to come into the dreams of this person. But when he is, he will. He's not ready. So please respect him. Please respect that. He was someone that had boundaries too. He had great boundaries. He knew. Spread your wings. Okay, there is this message for, I feel like there's someone, there's a niece or a nephew. I keep hearing niece, nephew. Maybe it's both. But he's saying to re to love on this child, rebuild your relationship with this child. Don't, or maybe a brother or a sister, family, a little girl, little kid, little boy, something like that. I'm hearing he wants the relationship to be rebuilt with that. He this person really this little kid really turned, or little kids really turned to him. But I'm picking up on a little kid. So this, maybe it's a boy. I keep hearing boy. So I'm gonna go with it. Maybe, this is doesn't have to be. Maybe this girl has a she could be a tomboy, okay? Maybe the little boy is feminine. Okay? I don't want to limit the reading. So it could literally be a niece or nephew that has feminine or masculine, more of either or traits. Something about that, the family is not nurturing the child correctly. So he's upset about that. He wants you. Or he's worried as well. Maybe not so much upset. He's saying, I'm worried. I'm worried about that child or those children. And this could literally be the youth that he affected. Okay. Again, don't want to limit, but I am hearing a specific re relative that is young. He's saying that please help that person. Please help the little kid. I'm saying that. just because I don't want to limit the gender. He's saying, please help. You guys know who that is. Control. Let go of the control. There's nothing you guys could have done. He lived his life how he wanted. He moved how he wanted to. Okay? I feel like they're waiting for awaiting results. There will come out more truth about him. His family will get what is rightfully theirs, well deserved. He wants a lot of the money to go to his family and this little kid too, I think. He wants the money to, okay, that's what I'm hearing. He wants the money to go to the child to pay for the college tuition. This child's very bright, very creative, but gets shunned. He relates a lot to this kid, guys. Relates a lot to this child. So I don't know if he had a child or if this is a relative or a niece or nephew. Again, I don't want to limit. So I don't know anything about him. So, but he wants the money to go to that child as well. Some of that money to go to the child and to the family. But he's saying, please let go. There was nothing you guys could have done. Nothing. Lead and balance. He's saying to please let him go. That's what I'm hearing. Everything will right itself. But learn to be a leading family and learn to balance what is good and what is bad. Okay? Perfect. That's beautiful. Thank you, Jarad. Thank you, Jarad, for coming through. We wish you and your family the best of wishes. I really love that we connected. And for anybody who watches this that is a fan of him, of Juice WRLD, Jarad, aka Juice WRLD, he loves you guys. He is transcending. He is letting go, which is beautiful. This was the photo that I was looking at while I was channeling him. Just when you guys saw me looking down a lot, that's what I was looking at. So, you know, Jarad, thank you so much for coming through. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for speaking through me in the most positive way. We're going to go ahead and sage for him. And I'm going to go ahead and get out of here. And you guys wish him well. Pray for his family. Pray for him. Pray for this child, okay? He really wants us to keep this child in good spirit. So we're going to go ahead and he wants me to sage. So Spirit wants me to sage to wish him well. So that is what we're doing. Again, great intent. Thank you, Jarad, for coming through. Thank you so much for welcoming me into your energy as much as you saw fit. I wish you well in the spiritual world and to transcend higher and to release any demons and anything in your past life that has held you back. We love you. I know I didn't know you. I didn't listen to your music. But your family loves you, we love you, and we wish you well. God wishes you well, your family well. Amen, amen, amen. Okay, guys, so I hope you enjoyed that reading on Jarad, aka Juice WRLD. Please respect him. I'm going to go ahead and disable the comments just because this reading can get tainted, and I don't want that. All right, guys, love and light. Namaste.